Greetings fellow nerds. In this video we're going to make a membrane divide cell based on Nafion, a cationic exchange membrane. I actually shot this video about 10 years ago, so forgive the lower production quality. Wait, actually looking back I had a higher production quality back then. Okay fine, appreciate the higher production quality before I became a hollow fraction of the YouTuber I once was. Anyway, a quick introduction to why we want to make a membrane divide cell. So far we've done electrochemistry using undivided cells with both electrodes in the same solution. For simple experiments like making sulfuric acid from copper sulfate, this is great. But for experiments like making potassium chlorate, the efficiency is reduced. For more complicated electrochemistry like trying to separate the two ions in a salt, an undivided cell fails miserably. The answer is to somehow divide the cell using a membrane to prevent the ions we don't want from crossing over. This allows us to separate the ones we do want by electrochemistry. And that's the idea behind the membrane divide cell. There are many membranes available, but we'll be using a type called Nafion. Nafion is expensive, but because it's used in fuel cells, and fuel cells are very popular these days, Nafion is getting more and more accessible to the amateur if they have the money for it. This particular sample is N117, but you can buy cheaper N115, N112, or even some of the other types. They mostly differ in terms of physical strength, ionic conductivity, chemical stability, and so on. And as amateurs, we're not stressing them to their limits where these parameters would be a big issue. Anyway, I'm going to make a single compartment membrane separator cell, and I'm going to size it to fit one of my titanium electrode plates. I intend to use this for alkaline electrolysis experiments and chloralkali cells. Most divided cell chemistry is done using dual compartment setups, and someday I intend to make one. Although considering this video is 10 years old, looks like I never got around to it. Anyway, a single compartment is slightly easier to make and lets us fit into larger containers, so that's what we'll start with. I'm going to make it out of acrylic. Acrylic is very resistant to the sorts of chemistry I intend to perform, and because it's clear, we can see inside if there are bubbles or if there are solids depositing. So I've already crudely cut a bunch of pieces to the approximate shapes I want. The back plate is obviously the back of the compartment and should be larger than the electrode I intend to use. Here I have the separator plate to provide clearance between the back and front plates and slot the electrode into. And finally the front plate which makes the compartment and where we'll mount the membrane. The dimensions aren't too critical. I'm using 1/4 inch acrylic sheets and the only real important dimension is the exposed membrane surface area, which is this 5 by 5 cm crudely cut square. This will give us approximately 25 square centimeters of effective membrane and exposed electrode area, which will be important when doing current density calculations. You'll notice that I've cut the hole to be slightly smaller than the electrode. This is to absolutely prevent the electrode from being able to accidentally puncture the membrane. The membrane is expensive and hard for me to get, so I want it to last. Okay, so now that we have the pieces, we just bond them using acrylic solvent. Unfortunately, my camera didn't properly record that part, but it's very easy. You just put drops of dichloromethane or tetrahydrofuran solvent between the acrylic surfaces, and they'll bond fairly easily. There are plenty of YouTube videos on that process already. Look up acrylic solvent bonding. Now let me just test to make sure the electrode still fits. And it looks good. I'm going to cut and trim down the excess bits since we're almost done here. And here we are, it's still quite crude with all the little bubbles and imperfections, but this is good enough for our purposes. I'm not exactly trying to make art here. Now for those of you with 3D printers, it would be much faster, easier, and more straightforward to simply print the whole compartment using acrylic filament. And I strongly recommend doing that to save yourself time. Okay, back to the compartment. I've drilled a hole in the back so we can insert a tube. This will allow us to siphon off products as they form during electrolysis. All that's left now is to install the membrane. So here is the big reveal, the famous Nafion membrane, which is incredibly boring and looks exactly like plastic wrap. So why is this membrane so coveted and special that the small sheet costs $100? It actually has a few important features. As said before, it's a plastic polymer. But instead of being made of hydrocarbons, the backbone consists primarily of fluorocarbons similar to Teflon. This makes it extremely chemically resistant and can directly survive harsh electrogenerated species like persulfates, hypochlorites, and peroxides. But what really makes this useful rather than just being Teflon plastic wrap is the sulfonate groups incorporated into the structure. These sulfonates import an ionic charge to the polymer and make it an ionomer. It is permeable to cations but blocks anions. The cations can move from sulfonate to sulfonate group through the membrane and eventually be transported to the other side. So if we put an electric charge across the membrane, the cations will pass from one compartment into the other compartment, but the anions will remain behind. Now it's not perfect. Some anions do leak through, and the cations can diffuse back and reduce efficiency. But this opens up new avenues and applications of electrochemistry that previously were very difficult or even impossible. Okay, so let's install the membrane. In a professional divided cell, the membrane is clamped down between rubber gaskets and usually with screws or other removable hardware. This allows the membrane to be changed or fixed should the need arise. I'm just going to glue the membrane in place with some marine grade epoxy. For the amateur, the bulk cost is the membrane, and building a disposable compartment is more straightforward and easier to prevent leaks than building one with gaskets and removable hardware. Although by all means do that if you intend to do heavy electrochemistry. I've roughened the surface with a file so the epoxy can form a stronger mechanical bond. Perfectly smooth acrylic is very hard to glue anything to. You might be wondering why I'm not using acrylic bonding solvent. Nafion doesn't bond with acrylic at all, but it does bond somewhat with epoxy, and that's why I'm using it to bridge the two. Of course, you may further ask why I didn't make the whole compartment out of epoxy. Epoxy is not as chemically resistant as acrylic, so by having acrylic on the outside and epoxy on the inside, we can sort of get a workable solution. I'm also going to prepare this protector piece to go over the membrane. It can still get punctured by an external electrode, so this protector piece will help protect it. You might go further and add a plastic grill for further protection, but I won't bother. Okay, so let's place down the membrane and sandwich the pieces. I've already cut the membrane to be slightly smaller than the compartment. And there it is, all done. Now we just leave it overnight to cure, and preferably under some heavy weight so it doesn't slide off. And that's it, a simple Nafion membrane cell. It's pretty crude, and if the membrane fails, wears out, or gets punctured, we can't replace it and have to completely rebuild it. But it's easy to use, and all you have to do is put the whole thing into a much larger container, and that container now serves as the second compartment of a two-compartment cell. You can then load up that compartment with all kinds of chemicals and complex electrodes, and after you finish your experiment, you can just pull the membrane cell out and easily leave behind the products of the outer compartment. Personally, I'm going to use this in an upcoming video to make sodium hydroxide from sodium bicarbonate. So please subscribe, like, and comment, and thanks for watching. Special thank you to all of my supporters on Patreon for making these science videos possible with their donations and their direction. If you're not currently a patron but would like to support the continued production of science videos like this one, then check out my Patreon page here or in the video description. I really appreciate any and all support.